Hi, this is Benjamin Faust, instructor of economics, and I would love to go over with you just a slice of information about immigration patterns as it relates to income inequality between nations. Now, when you're talking about migration patterns, you can think of it this way. It's a very complicated thing, just like many things in economics and in life. And so there's a lot of reasons you might emigrate from one country to another. It has to do with your family status, economic opportunity where you're starting out from and where you're going to. Even age plays into it. For example, people under the age of 35 are way more likely to emigrate to another nation than are people over the age of 35. Now, I want to hone in on just one specific aspect of immigration patterns, and that is the income inequality between two nations. In order to do that, we have to kind of assume the two nations in question for the migration patterns are going to be relatively similar in terms of total income per capita, GDP per capita, and other things such as maybe even language and culture, opportunity, things like that. And the only thing we're going to set differently is the income inequality. And so here on the board, I have in red on the left side, high inequality nations represented by two bars, and they're kind of spread apart because in this nation, there's a high degree of inequality between the very top echelon and the very bottom earners of the economy. And on the right side here in blue, I have a representation of a low inequality nation where the top echelon is much closer, comparatively speaking, to the bottom echelon, representing that this nation has less inequality. And so here's how the migration pattern works. If you are in a high inequality nation and you expect that you're going to be on the bottom tier of earners when you migrate, and you might even be before, you're gonna tend to say, yes, I would like to emigrate to a lower inequality nation, all other things being equal. And so what happens is you're gonna come up here, and there you go. And let's go ahead and turn this chart into a little axis here. So on our axis there, that would be our y-axis, we're gonna represent income. And so as you see here, as you go up here, your income is going greater. And so, for example, here, you start out at income level here, and then you end up at income level here. So you're gonna get a gain from the migration from the high inequality nation to the low inequality nation. So that's the first thing. The second pattern is when we are in a low inequality nation and you're a high echelon earner, one of the top earners, you tend to want to migrate, all things being equal, to high inequality nations. I'll denote that with a purple arrow there. And what we have going on there, of course, is if you are, you start out here at this income level and you end up here, so you get a raise when you do so. Now, again, immigration is a very complicated subject, but it would be unlikely that you would be in a high inequality nation as a high earner, all things being equal, and go to a low inequality nation. It would also be unlikely that in a low inequality nation, being a low earner, that you would go to a high inequality nation, because you would force yourself in both cases to have lower earnings. Again, this is a simplified way to explain a theory, and we have to make a lot of assumptions to do it, but in general, this holds true.